Good morning, teachers and classmates. I am Gabriel Cheng from Group 5. We are doing task work on real-world problem for cost of producing drink cans. So let's start off the problem. So understanding the problem part, when we make the solution assumptions to simplify the problems, first, we assume that the canned drink being used for modification is a normal Coke can of 12 ounces, 355 ml. Second, we assume that a can's dimension are 4.83 inches high, 2.13 inches in diameter, and the top and 260 inches throughout the rest of the cylindrical can. Third, we assume that the volume of the can drink will remain the same of 355 ml. Next, what information is required to accomplish the task? So first, we need the volume and dimensions of a normal can drink, the total surface area of the can, and the cost of producing a metal can before and after the increase of the price, so that we are able to accomplish the task of trying to reduce the total surface area in order to reduce the cost price.
Okay. I'm Yilin. The information given is to make the total surface area smaller but keep the volume of the drink the same. Reduce the total dimension of the drink can in order to reduce the cost price, as the rising metal prices will cut profits of manufacturers. The mathematical models or tools that we use is Google Excel sheet.
Next, we devise the plan to solve the problem using our guess and check. So the fixed volume would be 355 ml. So our formula is volume equals to pi r squared, height total surface area equals to 2 pi r h plus 2 pi r squared.
I'm Vera. We assume that the volume of the can does not change and the radius and the height does not affect the surface area. Out of the two solutions, we chose solution 1 instead of 2 because it is easier to understand. Using this table, you can find out that the dimensions of the can with the smaller surface area is having a height of 7.06 and a diameter of 8. Using the same formula, we without affecting the volume of the can. Using this method, we decrease the height and make the radius bigger, and we found out that the minimum surface area is 278 cm².
I'm Coris, and looking back, let's review the assumptions made. How can the model be improved until an adequate solution has been found? Use different variables such as the height or volume as the main subject. Change the values accordingly, so that the goal of minimum surface area can be obtained without affecting the volume of the liquid the can hold. How can our modeling strategy be extended to related problems? This modeling strategy could be put to use in efficiently making space to be able to put more items into the cabinet to store. This could help save space in the kitchen, and it will be able to make items easily accessible and improve the comfort of the home.
I'm Wei Hung. So let's present the real-world solution that was given to us. We used the guess and check model to try and put in different values in order to get the smaller surface area. We had to check and confirm every time after we put in a new value so that it doesn't affect the volume of the liquid, which is 355 ml, so that we can get the desired outcome of minimizing the can's total surface area, which would affect the amount of liquid it could hold.
Okay, so lastly, let's reflect on the real-world solution. Was it adequate? Okay, so we were given limited information on the situation where we had to work with some unknown values in order to minimize the can surface area. We had to use volume as the fixed base of 355 ml and work around the height and the diameter of the can to reduce the amount of metal used to reduce the amount cost of raw materials, which was affecting the company's profit. So we used a guess and check method in order to reduce the amount of metal used to the minimum. So it was hard to accomplish the task given, we were then able to get the desired outcome, which would reduce the metal used and design the can to contain the same amount of liquid in the can of 355 ml. So these are the reference used. Q&A sessions, and our reference pictures. And lastly, thank you for listening to our presentation. We are from Group 5.